So, thank you for the interview, Coach Tim Cohn. So, I think this is our first time to went to the semis and beat one of the strongest team in Europe, which is Latvia. And we're close to go to the Olympics, even though in the semis we've been beaten by Brazil and we lost Kai because of the possible rib injury or bruises. That's why you don't force Kai Soto to play. So what are you disappointing of, wherein you can, you already made a point that the Gilas team made it at least in the semis?
I'm incredibly disappointed. I'm disappointed for the players. I'm disappointed for the country. You know, it's funny. We went there with, I'm not sure what our expectations were. We really wanted to just prove that we could play with the European teams. And, you know, we knew we'd done well in the Asian games. We know we did. We could handle Asian teams. But the next step up for us was to play against the European teams and see if we could step up against them. And we did. And then once we did, once we beat Latvia and competed against Georgia, the game we could have won, we could have put it into overtime and won, but we didn't on purpose so that we could make sure that we got to the semifinal. But after that, we really wanted to win the tournament. We really felt that we had a chance to win the tournament. You know, the ending at this particular tournament was bad, but it's not really the end. It's a really good beginning for us. Mm. As we continue this quest over the next 4 years to the World Cup.
So we went to the semis and we need two wins, but we lost to Brazil. That's why we are kind of off and we don't make it to the Olympics because of that loss. What do you think the problem? Because I watch and during the first and second quarter where seems okay, but we collapse on the third, especially on the fourth quarter. Probably because of we lose Kai, or because of the players are not really, I'm not saying not really into winning the championship, but the Brazil are really crunching all the threes and the shootings are, the percentage are really big. Why do you think what happened and why we lost in the Brazil, which is very important for the Gilas team to win that tournament and to be qualified in the Olympics?
Well, I think we're just a little worn down. I think that there's a lot, you know, there's so many hindsights. There's so many coulda, woulda, shoulda. You know, you look back on it, and at the time, we felt comfortable leading them by 6 points, but we also said at halftime that we had made a lot of tough shots and Brazil had missed a lot of open shots. And if we had not, if we didn't change that in the second half, they were going to take us apart. And it turned out to be prophetic. Mm-hmm. Hitting their shots, we continued to take tough shots and miss them. There's so many what ifs. You know, what if Kai hadn't been injured? What if we had Scotty and AJ Edu and Jamie Malonzo with us? You know what? Those things always go through your minds, but. The bottom line was I felt at halftime, Junmar was really, really worn down already at halftime. Remember, it was his third game in four days, and he was playing. They were rotating two 6'11" guys, big, strong guys against him, and really physically up with him. And I think we just got out physical in the second half. And, you know, we look back on it and you think, okay, we could have done this, we could have done that, we could have gone to a smaller lineup. So many things we could have done. And the problem in this tournament is that you don't have a second chance. And that's one of the things we talked about. You got to do it right the first time. In the PBA, in the pro leagues, you know, you play a series. You have a best of three, a best of five, a best of seven. So it doesn't work out that night unless it's game seven. You got another shot at it. But in this tournament, you don't. You got to be at your best every night. And we just had a really, really bad quarter where we just kind of all panicked together, me included. And we saw it slip away, and we can just never recover.
As I mentioned earlier, Kai, I think, is a big factor, if ever, he play versus Brazil, but there's something happened when he play at Georgia. We're in almost, I think, in the middle of the second quarter. He got bumped so hard, and someone pushed each player, their opponent, and it caused collisions, and that's why Kai Soto got injured. Do you think Kai Soto is a big factor, or do we have a reserve seven-footer, same thing as Kai Soto's skills? Because I know we really need Kai Soto that time during Brazil game. What do you think about that, Coach Tim?
So if he goes out of a tournament, we're toast already. So it's not, you know, if there were a lot of 7-foot players to choose from, then we would do that. But we don't have that choice.
Another question: do you think Coach Tim Cohn, they already master, or they already study the triangle offense that you guys are doing? Doing in the game, and plus from the winning moments that we have, they already study what we supposed to do, because as you said, I think our opponent, the Brazil, already know the triangle offense. That's why they adjust and how they're gonna figure out to take advantage of counterpart, that kind of techniques that you have. What do you think about it? What adjustment you guys do when they already know that our offense and defense are based on triangle offense?
A practitioner of the triangle for 30-plus years, uh-huh. So I know the ability that it has. I know the ability it has to bring the players together. It's a great chemistry type of offense because there's a lot of ball movement. Everybody's sharing the ball. No one has an opportunity to be ball dominant. And so I think players generally, once they understand and they learn the triangle, they enjoy running it. But it is a little bit difficult. It is a little bit complex. I have to admit that. It takes a while to get into it and learn it. And that's something that we're still trying to do. That's a good question.
Regarding about injuries, since we only have less preparations for the tournament, and I know we don't have time for replacing players, but do we have an options ahead of time, since Kai Soto got injured? You think we have option plan A and B about if players are injured and there's a replacement? I know we have a solid 12 players only, but do we have an options, or right away we can just replace the players and put it on the spot if there's someone are injured like Kai Soto?
You know, it comes back to that issue again, at least pre-tournament. It comes back to that issue again. If you're going to get the players that you want and the best players in the country, and I think that's one of the things we proved in this tournament, that if you're going to perform, you need the best players in your country. If you're going to perform at a world stage, you can't bring a developmental team that's made up of college players or lesser pros and hope that they develop over time and get there, because you're just going to constantly be developing and you don't even know which players are really going to be your best players overall, mm-hmm. You know, 3 or 4 or 5 years from now. And I think that, honestly, our country is too passionate in their basketball to wait 3 or 4 years for a team to mature and get better.
Thank you, Coach Tim Cohn, for a short interview. I guess you are best coach you ever have as Gilas, and we are so thankful that Shot Race already resigned and decided to really leave Gilas, because you are the right person to inspire not only the Filipinos and the country, but also the players that playing in the Gilas team, and we hope you stay there forever. First of all, Coach Tim Cohn, we're so proud that you are in that position. And plus, you really deserve, and you're the best coach ever, winning championship in the PBA, and you prove to yourself that you are really worth it. And I hope Coach Reyes will never come back. So thank you very much for your service to the Filipino and to the basketball league. Thank you, Dusty.